2.0 SE Premium Lineartronic 2018 review, from £26. 4657. What is it? Subaru's rugged XV crossover returns for 2018 with plenty of promise. Built on all-new Subaru Global Platform underpinnings, it comes packed with safety technology and a 5-star Euro NCAP rating that ranks it, in terms of passenger protection, top of the compact family car class. It also retains core USPs of its predecessor, including proper permanent all-wheel drive and 220mm ground clearance, ensuring it remains a hardier option than segment alternatives like the Ateca and Nissan Qashqai. But the new car has lost a diesel option and so comes available exclusively with petrol power and a CVT gearbox, which is quite the contrast to the class norm for vast powertrain lineups and something that you might expect to hamper its chances of making a mark in such a congested segment. The thing is, Subaru's not concerned with taking on mainstream models such as the Ateca, but rather, more interested in growing its faithful customer base so that it achieves a targeted 3,500 sales overall in 2018. It expects the XV to account for about a third of that, so the real question is, will it be able to draw in new buyers, or is it destined to remain a car for Subaru's loyal but small customer base? What's it like? There's no denying the XV looks more purposeful than conventional compact SUVs thanks to the way it appears to be standing on its tippy toes. The car's 18-inch wheels are surrounded by thick arch gaps and its underside clears the ground with an extra 38mm compared to the Ateca. But the car's nose is longer and sleeker than most off-roaders, thanks in part to the low-set boxer engine beneath it, so it doesn't look cumbersome. Slip inside and the car trades the exterior's hardy theme for a more premium look. The new XV's dashboard and center console feature a much cleaner, more modern design than the old car, with a standard fit 8.0 in infotainment system featuring Apple CarPlay and Android Auto taking center stage. The layout remains functional with big buttons, but there's clearly been a concerted effort to boost the car's design appeal here. Our car comes with a 2.0-liter flat-4 Subaru expects to be the car's best-selling powertrain, but a smaller 1.6-liter boxer is also available. The 1.6-liter engine is new, while the 2.0-liter is a heavily reworked version of the previous XV's unit. On the move, the engine is noticeably smoother and quieter, and it also comes with stronger mid-range grunt to prevent the Lineartronic CVT gearbox, which is the only one of its kind adapted for an all-wheel drive car, by the way, from demanding too many revs. But with 145 pounds FT and 154 bhp on offer, powering hard for an overtake or to enter a motorway will still send the engine rev skywards. Turbocharged rivals pack a fair but more mid-range punch.